वेलकम टू डे वन ऑफ जीएम डाइट. सो जीएम डाइट फर्स्ट डे इज ऑल अबाउट हैविंग फ्रूट्स. इट्स अबाउट लेटिंग योर बॉडी जस्ट टेक केयर ऑफ इट सेल्फ. सो येस, यू कैन हैव एज मच फ्रूट एज यू वुड लाइक एक्सेप्ट हैविंग बनानास, बिकॉज देयर इज अ स्पेसिफिक डे अलॉटेड टू बनाना. सो वॉट आई एम हैविंग इज वन फुल एप्पल विद द पील. आई एम गोना लाइक स्लाइस इट अप एंड हैव इट. आई माइट हैव वन मोर, बट हैव एज मच एज यू वॉन्ट. यू कैन इवन ब्रेक डाउन योर मील्स. सो यू कैन हैव लाइक वन एट 12 o'clock एंड देन हैव लाइक लंच एट 2 एंड समथिंग like that. Now, apples and watermelons are two fruits I would really recommend on your day one of GM diet, because both of them are great, great, great to kickstart your body. Simply because watermelon is 70% water, so it's not about having extreme calories or having extreme sugars. Fruits like mangoes have extreme sugar, so they won't be as helpful as the other fruits. They're not gonna harm you or anything, but the fruits like watermelons and apples will be more helpful. Now, the thing with apple is that it's a negative calorie food. That means is it takes more calories to burn itself in your tummy than what it has. So yes, I would really recommend that you have apples and watermelons on your day one, as it will really help you and benefit you. Now, there are two very important things you have to keep in mind while taking the GM diet. First, you don't have to starve yourself. You keep yourself full with fruits or whatever, you know, the diet says to have that day. So keep yourself full with that. And secondly, do not intake any salt. Salt tends to give you a lot of water weight, because it retains water. Now, for 7 days, if you're not intaking any salt, you will get rid of all of that water weight. So if you have an important function coming up and you just want a quick fix, you can use this. It will suck in your tummy. But I would rather, you know, sort of say, tell this to you, that this is more of a healthy lifestyle living. So it will get rid of the water weight, which will eventually come back, but the excessive weight will go away. Hopefully that makes sense. And as for the fulfill thing, I like to split my meals into, you know, smaller meals. So I will have a breakfast, a brunch, a lunch, a snacks, and then a dinner. So I hope you get that. So I've had my breakfast about 9:30. So about 12, I will have something more. Like I might have another apple, I might have watermelons, which as I said earlier, are great for day one of the GM diet. It's 12:30 and I'm feeling a little hungry, so I'm having another apple again with its peel. Apple's peel is really rich in antioxidants, so it's great for your skin as well as for your body. So I'm just gonna slice it up and eat it, and I still have to take a bath, so I'll do it after like eating the apple. And also, if I did not mention it yet, we are starting with 69 kgs. I currently weigh 69 kgs, so yes, I'm hoping to go down by like 5 kg or something, because last time I did go down by 5 kg and I just like gained back only 2 kgs from that. So yes, like 3 kg was like the total weight loss even after like eating anything that I wanted to. So yes, I'm just gonna have this apple now, and then we'll probably have lunch by 2:30. For lunch, I'm having half a watermelon. It's not that huge, so I'm having half a watermelon which has been previously chilled, so yes, without salt or anything else. So currently it's 5:30 p.m. and I is hungry, so I is having more watermelon. I know I is wrong English, it's just that it's currently like trending sort of, but I'm having more watermelon. It's great for the body as well as I love having watermelon. So yes, I'm just gonna have a big bowl of watermelon like you can see here. So yes, I'm gonna have that. So that's gonna be like my snack thing. And I don't think I've mentioned it by now, but you should have about 8 to 10 glasses of water while having this diet. And on a specific day when you're going to be having tomatoes, you want to have 12 to 14 glasses of water. I will tell you when we reach there, but for now, make sure you have 8 to 10 glasses of water. Or I just like to carry my water bottle with me, which is not here right now. But yeah, I like to drink about 3 to 4 liters of water every single day anyways, like irrespective of this diet.
For dinner, I'm having some cherries and again some watermelon.
So welcome to day 2 of GM diet. So today is vegetable day and I'm preparing breakfast for myself. You can have this throughout the day as well, like the quantity. You don't want to add more to this. So for vegetables, you can have like a big potato or like 2 small potatoes. You can have any vegetable boiled, raw or baked. I'm gonna be making potatoes for myself, baked potatoes. So I'm taking these 2 medium-sized potatoes and I'm gonna be slicing them up in a wedge shape, and I'm gonna be baking them for my breakfast. The thing is, if you have a hearty breakfast, then all of your day is sort of like fixed and, you know, sort of good to go. So that's why I'm having potatoes for my breakfast.
I am keeping the skin on them, and you need to wash them really nicely before doing this.
Then I'm just gonna take my baking tray and I'm gonna wrap it with some foil, shiny side up. So I've arranged my potatoes, as you can see, just to make them a little bit more yummy. I'm just gonna squeeze half a lemon on top of them. This will sort of like marinate them.
And after that, just to add in a little bit of more flavor, I'm gonna add some basil to it. You can add fresh basil as well, that would be the best, but I don't have fresh basil with me, and that's why I'm adding just these dried basil leaves.
And then I've already preheated my oven at 250 degrees Celsius. I'm gonna bring it down to 200, and I'm gonna set my timer for about 30 minutes. And then I'm just gonna put my tray in for baking and shut the oven.
So I just checked my weight and I've dropped 2 kgs already. Obviously, having watermelon does make a huge difference. Even if you don't want to do this diet, you just have some special place to go the next day. Have a watermelon diet a day before it, and it's like a quick fix. Obviously, it's not like something's gonna last forever and ever and ever, but yes, if you are looking for a quick fix, that's gonna do it. And I'm sorry for my hair, but you gotta try it this morning, guys. Also, I would like to add in to this by saying it makes a difference, like what workout you're doing. Currently, I am doing 10,000 steps minimum daily. Sometimes I like to go up to 15, 20, depends on my mood that day and the time I have for steps that day. So yeah, I'm doing 10,000 minimum steps daily, as well as I'm doing some ab exercises. I'm doing like a 14-day ab challenge. So yes, your workout will make a difference in how much you will lose in these 7 days as well. So it's about 12:30 and I was feeling a little hungry, so I'm gonna have my snack time now. So I'm gonna be having a full cucumber. Cucumber again is great as it's 70% water, and especially in summers, it's extremely good for you to cool down your skin and everything. So yes, I'm gonna be having a full cucumber, and I'm not gonna be having it with the peel. I'm gonna remove the peel. As far as the before meals that I've had with peel, make sure you wash them really well before having the peel as well. So I'm gonna start prepping for lunch, and we're gonna be having capsicums or bell peppers for lunch. So start off by washing these really well and then just slice them up. And then I'm just gonna take a full lemon and marinate this with that. I know this might seem a little bland and stuff. You can add in like green chili if you want. I just have a very low tolerance for anything very hot or spicy, so I'll just put in a lemon. I'm just gonna take my baking tray again and line it with some foil. Again, shiny side up. Once your tray is all lined, all you wanna do is just drizzle your capsicum all around, and then just make sure you spread it out really nicely. If you don't, however, want to bake it, you can saute this as well. That will be really yummy as well. But I just like to bake my, you know, raw veggies more than sauteing them. My oven is already preheated at 250 degrees Celsius, so I'm just gonna put my capsicum in. I'm gonna let this cook for about 20 minutes. I set the timer for 20 minutes. Because this cooks quicker than potatoes, so you wanna make sure you keep on checking them. So it's 5:30 and again it is snacks time, so I'm again having a cucumber, a full cucumber. Now, as I said, cucumber is great when you're doing the GM diet. Also, I would really like to recommend infused water for anyone of you out there. You might or might not do this diet. Infused water is just great. All you want to do is just cut some slices of cucumber along with a few lemons and mint, and then put it in water and keep it for chilling for about 2 hours, and then you can sip on that water all throughout the day. It's great for your body. So it's dinner time, and for dinner I'm taking this medium-sized potato which is half boiled, and I'm going to be cutting it into cubes along with the medium-sized capsicum which I'm going to be cutting into squares as well.
again, just for a little bit of flavor, I'm going to marinate it with half a lemon. I'm just going to drizzle the lemon over the veggies. Then I'm going to mix them up a little and then start skewing them on a skew. And once your skew is all prepped, you are ready to put this in the oven. I've already preheated it at 250 degrees Celsius.
Do you see it rotating?
So now my skewer is all ready to be eaten, so I'm just going to remove the skew and eat it up.
Welcome to day 3, guys. So today we're going to be having veggies as well as fruits both. So you can have fruits and vegetables, baked, boiled, raw, whatever you like. So for breakfast I'm having one big apple, and then we'll see what I plan for lunch. And as my weight, it's still holding stable at 2 kgs less than what we started. So it's lunch time. I didn't really have snacks today because I didn't feel like it. But if you want to have snacks, you can definitely have snacks. So for lunch, I'm eating 2 medium-sized boiled potatoes. You can bake them, you can boil them, do whatever. I want to have boiled today because I've been having a lot of baked stuff yesterday. So I'm just going to have that. You can put on lemon on this just to make it more flavorful. I'll just put on some oregano on top of it just to make it my type. So yes, that's what I'm having. That's the best thing about GM diet though, that you don't need to starve yourself. You can have any amount, like unlimited amount of food that you want, which I think is great. So it's snacks time and I'm having one full apple.
So rather than eating the potatoes just like that, I just had half of that, and after 2 hours, I'm just baking them again. So what I'm doing is that I've just sliced them up in coins, like thick coins, if you can see. And then I'm just gonna be adding a little bit of lemon on top of it. Major flavoring comes from lemon whenever you're doing GM diet, because lemon is a good source of vitamin C. And the fact that we're in summers currently, the last time I did my GM diet, it was still winters, so I could get a lot of carrots and oranges and stuff like that. But now they're not that available. I generally like to do my diets with seasonal fruits rather than something that has been kept in the storage or cold storage for a lot of time. So yes, I've just squeezed some lemon on top of that. I've just squeezed a little bit of lemon on top of that, and now I'm going to be sprinkling some ajwain on top of that as well. This will again give a lot of flavor to it, and ajwain is a great digestive. So I'm just sprinkling loads and loads of this because I love the taste of ajwain, and I love ajwaining aloo as well, but this is like a twist, like a GM diet twist to that. So I'm just sprinkling loads of ajwain on top of these potatoes. And now I'm just going to put them into my oven, and I'm going to let them bake for about 40 minutes on 200 degrees Celsius. My oven has been preheated at 250 degrees Celsius like usual. So I'm going to bring down the temperature to 200 degrees Celsius and keep the timer for 40 minutes. So my potatoes are now ready. I'm going to relish them. They look quite yummy. If you're not doing the GM diet, you can just make these by adding in a little bit of oil and salt to your potatoes, and they would taste just out of this world. Keeping my dinner really light with a bowl full of watermelon. This is very light and healthy for your body.
So today is day 4, and from today onwards things get start a little easier. So today you can have 3 glasses of milk and 4 to 6 or 8 bananas depending upon the size. My size is quite huge, so I'll be having about 4 to 5 bananas. Now because today's diet is quite mundane and you can't really make anything with it, I'll not bore you guys over and over again with what I'm having. So basically you can have milk 3 times. So I'll be having one in the morning, one in the afternoon, one in the evening. And bananas you can have whenever you want. So I'll be having complimentary bananas with the milk, and because I'm quite full after having bananas in the breakfast, so I won't be having a snack time between my breakfast and my lunch, but I'll have one between my lunch and my dinner. So yes, that's that. And as for weight loss, we've still lost that initial 2 kgs only. When I first did my GM diet, I lost weight after the 4th day, so it was like whatever I lost was after the 4th day. So these 2 kgs are extra right now, so probably we'll be looking for more weight loss after today. Good morning guys, so today is day 5 of GM diet. As I said yesterday, things will start getting easier now. Also on a side note, I've lost another kilo, so yes, we're keeping a track on that. So as I was saying, things will start getting easier. So today you can have two options for what you want to eat. So the first option is that you go for tomato soup and boiled rice, 1 cup of each. Like tomato soup, you can have more than 1 cup. You can have one for breakfast and one for dinner, and then 1 cup of rice for lunch. But if you don't want to do that, you can also do like 1 cup of tomato soup in the morning and 6 to 8 tomatoes throughout the day. Now if you're doing this, make sure that you have more than 12 to 15 glasses of water, because tomato creates a specific type of acid in your stomach.
So for the GM Wonder Soup, I'm going to be taking one small cauliflower. This is quite small, as you can see with my hand. Then one green bell pepper, half red bell pepper, half yellow bell pepper, and one thin stick of carrot. And you want to chop these up. So once all the veggies are chopped up, I'm going to put them in a pressure cooker. You can also open some of them, but I like to save my resources. So I'm just going to put this into this and then add some water to this. I'd say about this much, like you can see here, this much water. I'm going to let this cook for about 2 whistles, or if you're open cooking them, then till the time the veggies are cooked.
I'm having the soup again for lunch. It's quite filling, so you won't need to eat in between as well, because you're good to go once you have one full bowl of this soup.
So it's snacks time, and I'm having one tomato. This is a medium-sized tomato. You can see with my hand how huge it is. So yes, it's just like a medium-sized tomato. I've just washed it real nice, and I'm gonna have it like that. You can bake this if you want, but I really like to have tomatoes like this, like raw. So yes, I'm having a tomato. You can also sprinkle black pepper over it if you want to add some flavor, but I'm just gonna have it anyways. For my dinner, I'm having 4 large uncooked tomatoes. Make sure these are uncooked. You want to have uncooked tomatoes. And as I said in the beginning of the day, also make sure you have loads and loads and loads of water with this. This is the day when you need to have the most amount of water, only because there are some specific acids that tomatoes produce in your tummy. So make sure you clean them out with the help of water.
And then if you're not a very big fan of having tomatoes, or you can't have tomatoes due to some medical issue, you can go for the GM Wonder Soup. Now this soup has a lot of veggies, and it's like a clear soup. So yeah, you can also add in a pinch of salt to it if you want to make it more tasty. Otherwise you can go salt free. I'm gonna go salt free. So yes, you can have that along with tomatoes if you want. So I'll be doing 1 cup of GM Wonder Soup in the morning and the night, and throughout the day I'm gonna be having tomatoes. So today is the second last day of the GM diet, and today you can have any vegetable that you want. So you can use any of the recipes from day number 2 and 3. Also, in addition to that, you can have 1 bowl of rice, cooked rice without the water, in lunch for lunch. So yes, for my breakfast I'm having that same GM soup, and this is great. I've also lost another kg, so yes, we're keeping a track on that as well. For my lunch, because I'm on the go, so I am carrying with me 1 bowl of rice, which I'm gonna have. So these are cooked rice without the starch water that rice leaves. You have to drain that to make sure that these rice don't have any starch whatsoever. Also, if you don't like plain rice like this, last time what I did was I added in peas and carrots, which makes it sweet and really yummy as well, because red carrots are not available right now. They're not seasonal right now. Only orange carrots are available. So I'm not doing that. I'm just having plain rice, and I don't mind having plain rice anyways. So yes, that was just a little tip. If you don't like rice like this, you can have it like that. For my dinner, I'm again having that same GM diet soup. This is great if you want to lose some extra kilos really quickly, and by this time you will feel that your tummy has started to get a little flatter. Even if you don't see a lot of weight loss, you will see that your tummy is starting to get flatter. So it's a really good idea to also measure yourself by inches with a measuring tape, or an inchy tape like we call it in India. So yes, make sure you do that as well. So my tummy has become a lot flatter than what I started with, so that's great. So yeah, I'm just gonna indulge in the soup, and because I was out, I also did have sweet potatoes or shakarkandi, but without any salt. I just had it with a little bit of lemon, and it was boiled. So you can have that if you're out and you feel a little craving or hunger, you can have that. So today is the last day of GM diet and my weight is holding stable, so that's a good thing. So for breakfast today, I'm going to be having a big glass of mixed fruit juice. This has pomegranate, mosmi, oranges, and I don't know what all, but it's just mixed fruit juice. It doesn't have any salt, so make sure you tell the person who's making your juice to not put in any salt or masala in it, just plain fruit juice. So for my lunch, I'm having one bowl of cooked rice, again without the water, without the starch. You want to boil it and you want to drain it. So yes, I'm having one bowl of that. Also, by this time, you will notice that your appetite has decreased a lot. Don't get, you know, tensed about it. It's just like a momentary phase because you're so used to having smaller quantities and like distributing your food. You will feel like having lesser foods. That's what I've noticed in both of my GM diets as well, because in the first beginning 2 days, I used to have lots of snacks and everything like in between meals. Now I feel full for a longer time, which is good for your body as well. So for my last dinner, I'm again making potato wedges, but this time instead of using oregano or oregano or however you want to say it, I'm going to be using fresh coriander as well as lemon to flavor my potato wedges. Also today I'll be baking them on a grill rather than a baking tray because I've already marinated them with lemon earlier, so don't need to sprinkle lemon from top. So I'll be baking them on a grill today. So guys, we officially come to an end of the GM diet. I've lost 5 kgs in total. So I started with 69 and now I'm at 64. So that's a great thing. Although you will gain back a little of this weight. For me personally, I tend to gain 2 kgs back because a lot of it is salt weight. So as soon as you intake salt, water will retain in your body and you will gain that water weight back. So yes, but still losing 3 kgs in 7 days is a really good situation that you're in. Now there are a couple of things you want to keep in mind. This diet will only work if you still focus on eating healthy. I'm not saying like the GM diet, but still healthy. You can't expect yourself to lose weight if you eat pizzas for the rest of your life and do this diet just for like a week. That's not gonna work, guys. Sadly, it's not gonna work. I hope it did, but it's not gonna work. And I cannot stress enough on the importance of exercise. Exercise makes a hell lot of a difference in your weight loss journey. If you are doing exercise along with GM diet, or you know, even without GM diet, if you're doing exercise, it will make a hell lot of a difference. But if you don't have time for exercise, you can still do the GM diet, which leads me to my next point, that is you must leave a gap of a month before redoing the GM diet. You shouldn't do a GM diet, give a 2-day break and then do the GM diet. No, please don't do that, guys. That's really harmful for your body. So yes, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed my vlog on my GM diet journey. And yes, let me know if you'd like to see more fitness videos. I would definitely love to do them for you guys. And I will see you guys next time. Till then, don't forget to check out all of my social media, which would be in the bottom bar as usual for you guys. And I will see you guys next time, which I said twice, but bye.